Denver Broncos hat? Oh, you're Broncos fan. Keen sense of the obvious, right? But it's a connection, right? Kind of lowers the barriers. You're ready to go on to the next step. And the next step is the introduction. And what I like to do is, after we've done the connection part, it's a cool shirt. Thank you. And I pause. Because I want to see if Marcus is going to give me his name. I'd like him to introduce himself first. If he doesn't, after a little bit of time, then I'll go ahead and introduce myself. Why would I like him to do it first?
It's him investing basically time or energy into the encounter.
I want it to be about you. It's not about me. It's about you. Everything we're doing here is about you. Okay. About 40% of people will introduce themselves when they come in. Oh, hi, I'm Lee, and this is my partner Barbara, my wife Barbara. Whoever that one is. So if I'm in a condo and it's a vacation rental condo, what I like to do after they come in, I will give them a hook. The first hook is, this is a two-bedroom, two-bath, fee-simple condo. And then I stop. Why did I stop?
Because the fee simple's a hook for conversation.
What's fee simple mean? Okay. If they stop and ask you what fee simple means, they have not looked at property on Maui before.
Correct.
Right? They have not. And so you have a chance to educate them, add value. If they say thank you and they keep walking, what does that educate? They know what fee simple means, right? You know the difference between fee simple and leasehold. Okay, so you're gonna have less discovery to do. And then I say, because a property manager used to say this to me, and I loved it, so I say to people that are coming into a rental condo, walk around like you own the place. They always smile, they always like that, and then they always take off and start looking. So at a vacation rental condo, I let them go. If it's a residence where somebody lives, I'm a little closer by. So if they're coming back through and we're kind of getting ready to wrap things up, kind of seems like they're interested, not quite sure. What I say to them is, if you're going to invest in a condo in Maui, there are four things you need to know before you invest. That usually stops them right there. If you want to know what the four things are, you have to come to my seminar next week. It's homeowners associations. How do those work? Because you look at our homeowner association fees, and there's a little bit of sticker shock coming from the mailing. Right? So Andrew's smiling. Rental options. A lot of people want to rent that property. If you're at a residential property, they may think they can buy that and do short-term rental. So rental options. Fee simple versus leasehold, and financing. Okay. I've had people at that point just sit down. Do you think we're connected?
Yeah. You give value.
And they're like, I really want to know about this. I really want to know what it is. I don't want to make any mistakes. And then the sign-in sheet. So you need to have a sign-in sheet. I've been to open houses where I forgot my sign-in sheet and I felt really stupid, right? You can get books from escrow. I just use a sheet that I made up on Excel that says name, address, phone number, email, and then I fill in the first line, right? Why do I fill in the first line?
Because you don't want to look like you're sitting too much.
Nope, better reason than that.
To show them how to fill it out.
Yeah. Copy. I want all of this information. And if you have somebody that comes in and they only give you their name and like a phone number, you want to ask them to fill in the other information. If they don't, then put something in there. So the next person knows that they're supposed to put that information in. So my last line is Al Talpas, 5734 Croydon Avenue, San Jose, California. And then put in a phone number and an address. It's my brother-in-law. He wasn't at the open house, but now the next person knows how to fill that out. Some people want you to sign in
as soon as they come in. John, you were gonna comment?
Well, I was curious as to what your talking points are on financing options with your four, but maybe it's not the form for it. I was curious.
You know, if it's a condo and, or people are buying investment property, we've had people come in and say, I wanna put 20% down, we'll cash flow if I put 20% down.
Gotcha.
Right, so then we're gonna talk, yeah, you can't really do, you gotta have 30%.
30 plus.
Yeah, so you have that conversation.
Got it, thank you.
Depends on, we can talk about why they're buying, first time home buyer, investor, residential. You know, there's gonna be different financing options for each.
Of course.
Reason that they're doing that. So some people want you to sign in when they walk in the door. My personal preference is I wait until I find out kind of who they are, what they're like. You know, are they really just looky-loos? Do I really wanna drip on them? Do I really wanna put them into my database? And then I measure that by four things conversation. And then the last thing I say before they leave is if you're really interested in real estate on Maui, I have a newsletter that comes out every month. You can send out just the Maui stats and come out of RAM. I can make sure you receive this every month by email if you don't mind giving me your email address. Okay. Over 50% of the people that come through will give you all their contact information at that point. And then you can set them up for a property drip, and you can set them up for all the other stuff that you do. And you can stay in contact with them. If they're just, hey, never been here before, we just saw the open house sign, thought we'd come in. Is this a timeshare? So we can let them go. But that's how to get their contact info. Okay. How's that? Ready to do open house?
Yes, sir.
All right.
What's on there?
What's that?
Have you done any of
it? I just call out there.
Page 31. Agent referrals. So getting referrals from other agents. So where are we going to meet agents that are going to send referrals to us, or how would we connect with them?
Caravan.
Is anybody at Caravan going to send you a referral? Maybe they've got too much business. They get a client that they hate and they want to send them to somebody else. So.
Family reunion?
Other islands. The other islands, could they sell it?
Can.
Yeah, they could. But yeah, I mean, I refer to other islands. I don't sell stuff on Oahu. I send referrals to people over there, especially Keller Williams agents. Right. Family reunion. Is that a good place to connect? Have you been yet?
Yes, sir.
Oh. And you get connections there?
Well, I got an email from, or a notice from someone in my
in your KW app.
Yeah, and it was somebody from Vegas sending out saying, hey.
We'd like to have a referral agent on Maui.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I, because I'm a newbie and it's the only white message I got in there, I'm like, oh, wow. But I'm sure she just sent it to everybody, you know, and everybody accepts her and then, you know, any other relationship. So, and then after that, I get to feel very special.
Oh, so they sent out a blast to to get your attention,
yeah.
And you accepted it.
I don't know if I accepted it.
Oh, you don't know if you accepted it.
Well, because I just assume that I'm like, I'm a newbie, nobody knows about me, so this is just gonna be a...
So, if I can get into my...
It was from someone, I don't know, I seen this one.
Oh yeah, I think I got that one in the last couple of days.
See, I wasn't very special for this.
So, what I do is I accept it, then I click on view.
And then delete it.
No.
Just like Instagram. Oh, okay. Just like Instagram.
I'm prospecting here. Work with me. Come on. Give me a little help here. I have a canned response that I send back.
Oh.
Okay. Because you just accepted. She doesn't know you or you or you. I send back, thank you for the invitation to connect on Kelly. It's great to have a connection like you in Las Vegas. My Maui team and I specialize in second homes, investment condos, and 1031 exchanges. If you have anyone that's been dreaming of a property in paradise, We've got the expertise to assist them like they are Ohana family. And we will do you proud, and we happily pay a 25% referral fee.
Can you forward that to me?
Send me a friend request. If you want that, send me a text so I'll remember to send it to you and I have your contact information.
I'll keep it a little bit. I'll take it to the team first.
Yep. But if you just click accept, how special are you? Right? It's just like when a lead comes in and you don't really do very much to add value, do something that's going to add value. Why should they do business with you? Give them a reason. Okay. So Kelly, I get a ton of those. I've had a couple referrals that came through that way. So, and I reach out and touch them and try to connect. Agent referrals, family reunion, mega camp, there are other kinds of, there are workshop opportunities. One of the things I was taught is if you're doing your CE, or if you're doing like a GRI class or something like that, any opportunity you have to take that class that's not on Maui, go and take the class, right? So fly to Oahu, take the class. Fly to Lake Tahoe, take the class, right? Because are there referral opportunities there? Plus you get to be on vacation.
And write it off.
I'm not a tax expert.
Right.
You can write that off, right?
I have a question.
Sure.
So, this girl who sent us, is she with Keller Williams in Vegas or no?
Yeah.
She is.
Yeah, if you're not with Keller Williams, you don't have Kelly, right?
Okay, that's what I'm thinking. So, but then you can work with any, as for referrals.
For referrals.
Right. Keller Williams. Okay. But I was just
any
thinking that I was like, oh, I can work with anybody, but then she must be with Keller Williams and she was in our app. Okay.
Yeah, so I go to, been to NAR conference. I'm meeting people from all the other brokerages, independents. I have Canadian realtors that refer to me. The owner of KW in Vancouver is a friend of mine. They refer people to us. So you're Canadian. I would leverage that a little bit. Okay. So agent referrals. Let them know. I happily pay a 25% referral fee. That's what I say. Let's talk about social media a little bit. Who in here is an expert in social media?
Just dog pictures.
Just dog pictures.
Lost dog pictures. Bad dog.
So you have a lot of friends that like dogs. You've got a connection, you have something in common. There's already a warm contact right there. Right? That's not a cold call time for this week. Okay. Social media, I'm gonna focus on just a couple of items on here. Facebook. So how many of you have set up a Facebook business account? You got one?
Sorry.
You got two?
Not for this business.
All right, so you're going to set up a new one for this business? Okay. How hard is it to set up a Facebook business account? Okay, what do you have to do, Cherish?
I think it's to go to settings and then...
Set up a new account?
Yeah.
New account?
Add a page or something like that, add a business.
Okay, all right. Does that sound about right?
That's
simple,
yeah.
That's about right. Okay. So what I would say is, first of all, set up your business account. Post your real estate stuff in your business account and share it to your personal account. Okay. We're advised to not be using Facebook for our real estate services. We've been advised by social media experts that hardly anybody's going to your business page, so you need to promote it on your personal page. So the rule of thumb is maybe 8 or 9 posts about being social to 1 post about real estate. John, you said that you've been getting some leads.
Yes, sir.
What have you been getting? What are you doing?
I'm with the 808 team, so they put out targeted ads on certain properties, and when you click on the learn more, you've got to add some information to that to get to that next page that gets captured. I get an email, and I get 2 minutes to call them back. And then if I don't connect with them, I send them a quick text off of the app, I'll follow up with email afterwards, and after the races. That's why I've been getting up and leaving and stuff.
Right, because you're getting leads from Facebook on that. So that's an app through command. So you pay, it's a small fee to post that. It's very targeted. We do that with our listings as well. And it is, the dollar, it generates more leads than anything else that I do on social media. So if you want to post something on social media like that for a listing, talk to the listing agent so that you can try to do that. What else can you do on Facebook?
Prospect.
Prospect? How do you prospect?
Let people know that you're a realtor now, that you've been, that you might have some value to add to them.
Yeah, and somebody might say, congratulations, you got your license.
I actually have had my license for a year when I first posted that I had an open house, and everybody was going, congratulations, you got your license. And I was like, I had it for a year, but thank you.
Yes, that's there. We'll take that.
Yep.
Okay. You can post up something that's specific about a neighborhood or a complex. I've seen people start like Facebook sites for condo complex, right? So you become kind of the source of expertise. Use images. So if I'm at kind of Pauly Shores, I'll walk out, look at the beach, take a little video of surf, upload that to Facebook. And, you know, you get like 200 likes and comments on it, wish I was there, stuff like that. So that generates some opportunities for you. Post events. So if you have events, what kind of events could you post? Open houses would be one. What else?
We can anything like that. I mean, there
were... Big event at the dog park?
I was going to actually say something different.
So. Oh, okay.
But no, if they're having like, I don't know, a barbecue close by, like if it's a beachfront condo and they're doing like a beach cleanup or something like that, you'd be like, hey, this is going to be held outside.
Yeah.
Ask for volunteers or say you're going to be there volunteering, come on out.
Yeah. Yeah. People respond to that kind of stuff. They love it. So.
What about construction? Like, you know, new, like if there's a, you know, because if we're new, I mean, I don't have any listings and I can't really post them. Have to be
creative, so can I say,
hey, there's like talk in the news of this area being developed into
FYI,
like informing.
Yeah, Bob's saying absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely.
I see agents, and I used to do it, I don't do it anymore, but I would see agents go to Caravan and say, hey, I'm on West Side Caravan today, we're looking at this unit at kind of Pauly Shores, and I'm doing a video or I'm doing Facebook Live walking through there. So when I do, when there's the Halloween parade in Lahaina, I do Facebook Live, right? And you've got all the thumbs are going up and the hearts are going up. And, you know, people are connecting on that, right? So you can use it to promote real estate, you can use it to promote something else. It shows that you're a part of the community. Posting your listings, so we post our listings on our business site, and then we encourage all of our team agents to share them, and then other Keller Williams agents share them. So there's a lot that you can do on Facebook. You can put links to landing pages for our listings on Facebook. You can put links to a place for your own open house. Put the MLS link on there, right? So people can see that. All right, so how many people are going to go set up a business page this afternoon? All right. Twitter, how many people have a Twitter account? We have one. So we have a Twitter account, and all of our new listings get posted on Twitter. But Donald has never tweeted me once. I keep waiting, but yeah, I'm not getting any tweets back. So don't get a lot of action on Twitter. Pinterest,
right, you want a Pinterest site, and you're gonna say yes, right?
Either way,
yeah. The one that's hot right now is Instagram, right? Everybody on Instagram?
Mm-hmm.
So if you've got Facebook, you've probably got an Instagram account, and even when I'm watching like the late night TV shows, they say, look for us on Instagram. So that one seems to be one of the hot ones right now. And kind of buried back here on page 35. What? LinkedIn. What about LinkedIn?
Business.
So it's business and business. It's professional and professional. So I don't get a lot off of there, but I do get a lot of people that try to connect with me. The one that's really hot, though, is YouTube, right? Do you have a YouTube station? I get, how many people have a YouTube station? Marcus, you do. How hard is it to set up a YouTube station?
Very easy.
What do you do?
If you have a Google account already, you pretty much just tell it you want to start one, and it fills in the blanks for you for the most part.
And if you don't have a Google account, how hard is it to sign up for a Google account?
It's super easy.
It's like, we already know everything there is to know about you. Just, that's what's scary. How popular is YouTube? It is the second most used search engine in the world. Right? So, should you have a YouTube channel? What can you put on your YouTube channel? All the stuff we were just talking about. Okay, there's a beach cleanup event today. Walk out on the beach, shoot a 30-second video, shoot a 1-minute video, post it. Fireworks, 4th of July. Post that. I'm looking at a property. Post that. All of those things you can put on a YouTube channel and people search those. So I would really encourage you to just do a little video of yourself. Right, and I see people rolling their eyes. I did one about 2 weeks ago about foreclosures. We're seeing foreclosures again. There's a foreclosure in Juanitapoco. Value's probably $1.3 million, $1.4 million.
It's cheap for Juanitapoco.
It's a cottage with not the biggest view. Things sold for $9.96 at auction. But took a video in my car. I had my hat and my glasses on. So I'm like hiding out and posted that on YouTube and Facebook. I started getting emails. People really wanted to know about that. So it was like 40 seconds long. Foreclosures are coming back. Here's what you need to know. Call me for more information. And so people started communicating with me. So I really would encourage YouTube. One of our agents, Don Harris, he's on the ALC. He goes to the caravans, videos the property, gets that posted up, and he has built a business around posting those things on YouTube and Facebook. And he's doing the higher end business, luxury business. So just get out there, practice it, practice shooting whatever you do, and look at it. Don't be worried about it. You can erase it and do it again. The last thing I'm here for social media is a blog. So if you don't have a blog site, go to activerain.com. I think that's still free. And if you want to focus on a certain area, say a neighborhood, I would start blogging about that neighborhood. So articles that tell you something about the neighborhood, have the neighborhood name in there. And as people start searching for those properties, your blog will pop to the top. The reason that you want to use ActiveRain is because Google is very focused on ActiveRain. It bots that crawl over it, it finds your articles, and they will start to come up in your search, high in your search. We use that to get listings that we have a landing page, we want to get that to the top of the search on all shores. We put that out on ActiveRain a couple of times, and then pretty soon you Google on all shores, and that listing is at the top of the Google search.
So it's a way to connect with agents that are off island because it's really an agent-focused site. But if you're going to focus on a neighborhood, start writing little articles about it. And if you have trouble writing, write it anyway. Right? So all you're trying to do is get your name out there. You're the neighborhood expert. You're a trusted resource, and you can add value. All right. So now, 10 minutes of you guys pairing up and talking about what you're going to do for social media. And on page 36, there are some suggested topics. So why don't you just turn around, you three guys can get together back there. Talk about what your strategy might be.
Do you have a Facebook business? You said you have your own as a group.
I have a
Facebook business. That's a thing with a team.
That's why I'm on the
Yes, sir.
Yep.